notice he stays right on the spider. He needs to do that.
Great body slam by Odell Buckingham. Again, Tony the Spider on the mat.
Tony has to be losing his breath by now. He's took too many back drops.
Odell with his weight right on Tony.
Good belly to belly.
Odell Buckingham with the mat. Tony the Spider still laying there. I'll tell you what. Tony the Spider took every bit of Odell's weight and moved down to the mat. Folks, Bulldozer and Gypsy.
Richie Rouge, a few weeks ago I challenged you here on TV at the NAIPW. Now I want to know why you haven't accepted my challenge, boy. Are you afraid of me, or is it true what I've told everybody that you're a daddy's boy? Or are you just a little yellow-bellied coward and you ain't got guts enough to get in the ring with me, boy? I'm going to leave you laying when you do. That's a promise, mister. I'm going to take you apart like you ain't ever been took apart. I'm gonna let your old man know and your old mammy know that she ain't nothing and he ain't nothing and you ain't ever had nothing, boy. So I'm going to tell you something. You put your name on the dotted line, mister, because I'm hot and I'm mad right now, boy, because you're a coward. You're a lily-livered, yellow-gutted coward, boy. So you come on down and you accept the challenge, mister.
We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, Tony the Spider.
I got a new name for every opponent that gets in the ring with me. I call them pedal pushers. If you morons know anything about it, you know where I'm putting them. Tony the Spider means business in IPW, and I'm going to take everyone I can out.
Now let's go to the ring. Johnny Malibu in this match up against Motley Crue.
Crue's one of the veterans of the IPW.
And Johnny Malibu, a great, great wrestler. He's built well, and he's ready to fight. Ready to get ready.
You know, Malibu really impresses me.
Malibu with Motley, and starting things off with a great, great body slam. Another body slam. Enough to make Motley mad, I think.
And a hip toss into a drop kick.
Uh-huh.
Right into an arm drag.
Motley. Unbelievable, Mark Motley on the mat, and he's usually up and at him.
That's what I was talking about, Malibu impressing me. He stays right on Crue's like he should be, because Crue's is a veteran.
Malibu with an arm bar. Motley kind of contemplating what he's going to do next.
Crue's is not only a veteran, he's a sneaky veteran.
And so methodically moving around, if you'll watch, he just kind of figures out what he's going to do.
He does. When he's in a predicament like this, he's steadily thinking of his counter move.
Motley with pressure on the chin of Malibu, and Malibu still holding on that arm bar.
He intensified that arm bar, put Crue's back. But Crue's is going to the tights.
Crowd talking to the referee, I assume, and Crue's went to the tights.
And that stopped Malibu.
Crue's took something, it appears, out of his tights and laid one on Malibu pretty hard. Malibu, though, coming back with pull.
He blocked it right back to the arm. That's a smart move.
That wrist is putting pain on. Oh, what a flip now with the wrist. That's a lot of pressure on the wrist to flip a man of the weight of Motley Crue.
And right back to the arm bar.
Johnny Malibu with Motley Crue on the mat. And Johnny Malibu at the apparent advantage right now.
Says a lot for Malibu just to have a man like Crue on the mat.
Paradise City, that's where Malibu claims to be from, and it's kind of a regular you'll hear about him in some of his interviews.
Yeah, we talked to him in some of his interviews. He told us about Paradise City.
Right now, he's in a kind of Paradise City. He's got the advantage on Motley at the moment, but you can never tell what's going to happen.
You notice he's putting the pressure on that arm with that arm bar.
A lot of pressure.
Again, he intensified that pressure.
The look on the face of Motley Crue at that time, that tells the story itself. Punch to the face.
You stop and think about that look, it'll give you cold chills.
Another punch to the face. Motley Crue putting something back in his tights.
Well, he's experienced and the referee didn't see it. The referee can never catch him.
Slingshot off ropes, a duck, and Malibu right back with an arm drag, Motley on the mat.
And right back to the arm bar, that's smart wrestling. You pick out a body point and you work on it.
Motley at the disadvantage at this moment. It looks like it. You never tell about Motley. You never pre-guess this man.
You sure don't want to.
Motley back on his feet, or heading for his feet, trying to get up on his feet.
Yes, and Malibu's holding enough pressure that he can't make it. Well, he's made it to his feet now.
I think Motley kind of stepped there and just waited and thought a little bit while he was on one knee.
You notice he's pushing him back in the rope. The referee's calling for the break.
Motley knows exactly how much time he has.
Yes, he does.
That was a head right into the midsection, onto the chest of Malibu. Another head. And right into the side of the neck.
That hit him right below the ear, and you know that had to knock him off balance.
Again, into the side of the neck. Malibu gets the ropes, and Motley with a flying mare. We'll be back with more of this IBEW match right after this. Back with more IPW action. The match between Motley Crue and Johnny Malibu going real strong right now, Shane.
This has been a great match. Malibu has shown me a lot.
Punch to the face of Malibu by Mr. Motley Crue. I'll tell you what, this man is serious in his wrestling right now. Slam to the turnbuckle. Motley Crue putting some hurt on the Paradise City man right now.
Now he's just punching his face, and can you imagine what that feels like on his nose?
Look at the precise way he just walks away.
Malibu is down.
What a push for the referee to look like there.
There he goes, right back to the face, side of the jaw.
Oh, he's raking the face of Malibu on the rope. That hurts.
And those ropes are not smooth.
Now the referee getting on to Motley. Motley doesn't seem to really care that much, though, at this time.
No, but it is the referee's job, and he is a good referee. He wouldn't be in the IPW if he wasn't an experienced referee.
Malibu feeling the pain of Cruz's fist and an elbow right to the back section of the neck.
Put him right back on the mat.
Close those eyes again.
Malibu kicked out.
Malibu shaking his head. Oh, another elbow to the back of this Paradise City man. I'll tell you what,
if you notice, Malibu is continuously kicking out.
He's now at the disadvantage at the moment. Again, you can never tell about a match like this. Oh, what a fist to the face again of Paradise City man, Mr. Johnny Malibu.
Cruz is setting him up.
Kick.
What a kick.
That could have done it.
That could have broke some ribs.
I don't think so. This Malibu is a man that's taking a lot of pain and still coming back for more.
Malibu is double tough.
A legal kick, it looks like.
That was a legal kick right back to the ribs.
Malibu getting familiar with the mat again.
Molly was picking him up by the hair.
Pressure on the neck and everywhere on his body by Crue in this match. Reverse.
They kind of just run into each other there. Both men were stopped.
Motley getting slammed into the turnbuckle, and Malibu coming right back on him.
There's a lot of weight between these two men.
No reversal. Slingshot off the turnbuckle and a pancake. That is the classic.
That's all over. That's it.
Well, not yet. You can never tell about this Malibu man. There's a count. It is over.
You can almost bet when Crue pancakes you, it's all over.
Crue uses this a lot.
Look at that look.
There's that classic look. I don't think anyone else I've ever seen with eyes like that that can have such meaning in their look.
I will agree.
He held him a while after the bell, adding a little insult to injury, I guess.
Malibu's getting up slowly, but he did have a well-fought match.
Motley Crue taking the match from Paradise City man Johnny Malibu, a man with a great future in the IPW. I want to welcome to the IPW the gorgeous JR. JR, welcome.
That's right, Mr. Lee. The gorgeous one is here. After many weeks of contract negotiations, the JR and the IPW have finally got it together. 235 pounds of twisted steel and sex appeal. The men's fright and the women's delight. The toast of the coast with the utmost. And so fine, so very fine. I'm here for one reason and one reason only. That's to go after the gold and be the number one contender in this organization. I'm coming after all these wrestlers in the IPW. All of them, beware. JR is here. He's going to be there. He's going to be after you. So all of you get in line. I'm here for one reason, and that's to be number one.
In the blue trunks, Mr. Robert Sebring. His opponent, Randy wrestlers circling the ring.
Look how well Brian's put together.
Oh! And lock up and a knee.
Sebring's doing the right thing. He's coming out and opening up on Brian.
Sebring trying to take Brian out early.
And that clothesline almost took him over the top rope.
Brian feeling the pressure under this automatic jump by Sebring. He's going after his friend.
Well, this is Brian's first time at IPW, and he's getting a taste of it.
A duck from the clothesline, it looks like. Attempted clothesline by Sebring.
He might have barely caught him on top of the head, knocking him off balance.
Slingshot, a duck. A neck breaker.
And what a neck breaker. He's just driving that head into the shoulder and dropping that elbow into the shoulder.
The punishment seems to be reversed now. Now Sebring taking the brunt of this pressure that Brian is putting on him.
Brian is a tremendous athlete.
And Brian with a body slam on Sebring.
Right to the canvas.
Sebring laying there.
Well, Brian had him going his way, and then he took time to walk off. That could be a mistake. Sebring caught him.
Rake to the face by Sebring.
Right to the midsection.
Quick shot off the rope. A great backdrop.
I knew Brian should have stayed on Sebring when he had him down.
Sebring with a look of confidence in his eyes there.
Brian caught him.
What a crossbody block.
Well, he caught him high enough that Sebring's head hit right on the mat.
That's the match. And Brian with it. He evidently came right down on top of the head of Robert Sebring.
And Randy Bryant knew he had his man.
Richie Rude, you've been challenged twice on television by the Bulldozer. I want to know what's going to happen.
Well, you know, there's a fine line between ignorance and stupidity. And if there's one thing I'm not, it's stupid. I mean, let's face it, the man's 100 pounds heavier than me, about a foot taller. I don't want to step in the ring with him. But, you know, my daddy always taught me one thing growing up, and that's to never back down from a fight. And, you know, I've said it once, and I'll say it again. It doesn't matter who I have to step into the ring with, how much bigger they are than me, I'll be in there fighting every time.
We're back. This next match featuring tag team action with some of the biggest men in the pro wrestling world. Now let's go to the ring. In this exciting tag team match, JR and Bulldozer against the Mighty Nation.
He calls himself the Gorgeous One, JR, and the Bulldozer.
And this Mighty Nation, I think he's a mean Indian.
Well, they're used to tag teaming together, but Bulldozer and JR is not. He's hit down.
Bulldozer talking to JR. There's the bell.
You know, this Mighty Nation has a combined weight of almost 600 pounds.
Bulldozer, big man.
The Bulldozer would make up half of 600 himself.
A lockup.
Pushing him right back into the rope. And that stopped Bulldozer's momentum.
Bulldozer getting over the referee a little bit.
Well, Red Eagle with a clean break. He held his hands up. The referee knew that he didn't try anything.
Red Eagle's the taller up against Bulldozer.
The Red Eagle's 6'6".
A lot of height, 6.5 foot, and of course the weight differential, like you say, about the same.
You put 295 with 6'6", and you put Bulldozer at 300, that's a heck of a match.
Headlock takeover, Bulldozer now with Red Eagle on the mast, and Red Eagle coming right back to the scissors lock and getting out of it.
And he's got Bulldozer down.
Bulldozer taking a lot of pressure on his neck right now, those legs of Red Eagle.
That takes a lot to take a man like Bulldozer down.
Red Eagle first, holding out as long as he can. And Bulldozer's rope.
And Red Eagle right back up, ready to go.
Red Eagle taking loose and getting ready to tackle him again. We have some great arms right here. Look at the arms of these two guys.
Bulldozer has got a heck of a set of pythons there.
You'll see the pressure on these arms.
Referee's calling for the break.
That was right in the middle of the ring, and that looked like to me two freight trains meeting each other.
And then you notice Bulldozer went right back to the head.
Huh. Bulldozer put just in the end right into the knee
of the Gorgeous one, J.R. Hall. Now they've got Red Eagle in their corner right where they want him.
J.R.
That was a short driving fist. His nose hurt.
Gorgeous J.R. Well, I'll tell you. J.R. is showing some great moves right now.
He's staying on Red Eagle.
There's that rake on the rope. That's the face of Red Eagle.
I think he caught him on the forehead.
By J.R.
J.R. staying on top of Red Eagle.
No pain in the face of that injury right now.
Right into the rear chin lock. Red Eagle's in trouble.
J.R. knows he's got to keep him in trouble.
You can't let a man like Red Eagle get on top of you. If you do, it's all over. Red Eagle made the tag.
Now standing bare in for action.
There's a man of 300 pounds.
What's J.R. doing, Sam?
Well, he's offering the hand. I think it's just to stop the momentum of standing bare.
Show some veteran thinking right there.
Yes, it did, and then you notice he just attacked.
Swing shot off of the rope.
That's a double axe handle. You don't want to chop these Indians, though, because they'll come back on you.
I think JR's got it in his mind. He's got to do something to keep this Indian down.
And there was that big food of bulldozers.
Bulldozers just looks like probably the head. And you can see the size of that head, and you know it's hard.
You know that hurts.
When this man gets on you, you've got something on you.
Standing Bear knows that.
Standing Bear pays the punishment for Bulldozer.
He's got Standing Bear on the canvas. That's where he needs to keep him.
Standing Bear reaching out. Not close enough to get his part. Bulldozer reaching for a tag. Here's Jumpin' Jeff Farmer.
Well, he did it. Pinned me right there in the middle of the ring. There's always a lesson to be learned every time you step in the ring. And Motley Crue, you taught me one very good lesson. You took me out of my game plan. I couldn't wrestle my kind of match. Believe me, I learned and I learned well. It don't take me long. Next time I get you in the ring, you're mine. New tactics, new game plan. You're mine.
Hello, welcome again to another segment of International Pro Wrestling's A Visit with the Doc, where an apple a day won't keep me away. On this program, we're going to have to address a major problem in international professional wrestling, a problem that has upset me so much, I'm going to have to do something about. Now, when I turn on TV, I like to see that my wife and my children and the people that I know can watch a clean, wholesome family show. Now, I don't mind seeing Indians on TV. They're great in a John Wayne movie falling off the horses like they should be. And that's exactly the kind of setup that you want to see them. But you don't want to see them in the wrestling ring. Let's take a minute, if you will, and think about the Indians' contribution to history. Let's name some of the things they've done. That's enough time. Which leads me to the point of, we have probably two of the biggest non-athletes in international professional wrestling today. Again, I'm trying to figure out how they got into international professional wrestling. I don't know. Did they buy their way in? They can't be related to anybody, because I looked at all the crew and everybody associated with international professional wrestling, and none of them look stupid, which gives us to the final point. How do these people get in the ring? When you see them, look at their names, Bear and Eagle. Well, first of all, Bear looks like he lives up to his name. Looks like he's been sleeping too much, not spending time in the gym. Eagle, and we loosely call him the brains of the outfit, and we use the term brains very loosely, is the taller one. Again, you see him come in the ring. They come in off the reservation. They get through. They've been making moccasins and things for the tourists, and they get in the ring. It's sad. They have no athletic ability. They have no bodies. I'm out there. I'm doing things. I'm doing my manly 6-7 hour workout a day. I'm in there. I was going to enter the Ironman triathlon, where you swim and you bike and you run, but I didn't want to decondition myself enough to have to enter it. So it really upsets me when you bring these two losers in the ring. I've offered to wrestle them in a handicap match, which if you think about it, a handicap match is me against both of them, but anytime you put my brain against any Indian's brain, it is a handicap match. So they wanted me, I've tried to get them to meet me. Again, they won't. I've tried to be around them. I remember the first time I was around them and they were riding in my car. I turned on the radio. They were scared. They couldn't tell where the music was coming from. And when I actually lit a cigarette lighter, I thought they were going to bail out of the car. So what we've got here is two losers who shouldn't be in the ring, shouldn't be in the arena. Now, I'm not saying they're not fit to be in the arena. I mean, they'd be really good doing the only thing they'd be fit to do, doing this. Popcorn, peanuts, Coke, they'd be real good at doing that. But they have no business being in the ring with a man. A man with cannonball belts, gladiator pecs, barn door lats. Now, a lot of people say, Doc, do you like having that body? It's a good body to have, except sometimes these lats are so wide, in a good wind, I could get up off the ground. When I start spreading my lats, it looks like a manta ray. It looks like a man body. So I'm going to take it upon myself to get in the ring one of these days and rid international professional wrestling of those Indians once and for all.
Let's go to the ring for the next match. In this match, Tony the Spider against Jumpin' Jeff Farmer.
Spider is a very controversial wrestler.
This Jumpin' Jeff Farmer, lock up.
Tony the Spider just driving Jumpin' Jeff Farmer back into the rope. A little slap there.
A little slap from Tony the Spider, and that kind of started things off right on there.
Tony the Spider. He's talking to the ref. Jumpin' Jeff Cody's there.
He's telling the referee a bunch of things. The referee trying to keep a good watch on the... Whoa! Scissors lock to the head of Total Spider by Jumping Jeff. This could be very painful, Shane. At the wrong time here.
Jeff just slapping that leg and putting the pressure on.
Jumping Jeff, usually better in the air than on the mat, but right now he's doing a great job on the mat.
You see Tony the Spider holding those ears. He's in trouble.
Circling.
It's like having crossbite when you come up out of that. Those ears are burning.
Well, like a little kick there from Tony the Spider and starting to hit the back, and now Jumping Jeff up again.
Spider going for the suplex. And he got it.
Great vertical suplex by Tony the Spider.
Off his hand now.
Check out.
You see how far
Jeff is
ready to stay in the match.
Spider. Back to that front face lock.
Look how punishing it is. He just lifted Jeff up. Two atomic drops in this match, and Tony the Spider has got tremendous trouble with the lower back.
Wrestlers circling in the ring, lock up. Great arm drag.
I didn't do an arm drag, but I never did. And putting the pressure on Tony the Spider. Now he's in trouble. He's just up in pain. He's already out of his home.
Jumping Jeff, determined. Tony on his feet. The fist. Midsection, a couple of fists in the midsection. Body slam by Tony the Spider.
There's some hesitation there. I think Tony should get right back on Jumping Jeff. He should not hesitate.
Another body slam by Tony the Spider.
Now he's going for the cover.
Referee counting.
No, he couldn't hold.
Kick out. Farmer.
Ooh, there's the shoelaces.
Tony the Spider is seriously trying to hurt this man. Jumping Jeff.
He's doing his best to shake it off, but Tony's right back on it. That was to the eyeball.
Jumping Jeff still on the mat with these. Tony the Spider still taking advantage of this.
Now he goes to the nose. He's worked on every part of the face.
Tony the Spider kind of bragging a little bit there, maybe.
Well, he wants the fans to see what he's got. I don't think they approve. And Tony with some fist to the face. That one didn't connect very well, but he already had Jumping Jeff dazed.
Slingshot into the turnbuckles.
And he drove that shoulder into the midsection.
Now Tony the Spider. Now going Jumping Jeff. Fist to the road of the way.
Farmer was on his knees. He just drove the fist on that, going for the suplex. Jumping Jeff with a small package.
Referee down and counting. That looks like the ropes.
Tony the Spider knew where the ropes were. He got a foot on. That was the only way to break that hole.
Tony the Spider and Jumping Jeff firing on each other. Jumping Jeff coming right back on him with a great
standing drop kick. What a safe drop kick for Jumping Jeff. That goes back to the top line.
Jumping Jeff now slinging Tony the Spider into the turnbuckle. Slingshot off the ropes. Clothesline.
And it looks like Tony the Spider is down and out.
Could this be it?
Referee's counting. No, Tony the Spider was able to kick out.
Tony the Spider. Now back on his feet with a little help from Jumping Jeff.
Backing him into the turnbuckle.
This could be dangerous. Slingshot into the other turnbuckle.
Here comes Jumping Jeff. He's going for a victory roll. No, Tony the Spider just collapsed from under him. He was too worn out.
What a predicament.
The referee is calling for the break. Jumping Jeff frustrated.
You can see anger. And there. Great drop kick by Jumping Jeff.
A standing drop kick. And that put Tony the Spider back on the mat.
Jumping Jeff snatching Tony the Spider up by his hair.
Going for the suplex. And he got it.
Now there is some dangerous territory. Tony the Spider is on the mat. The result of a suplex. He is exhausted.
Jumping Jumping Jeff firing right back on him. Tony the Spider is just out on his feet.
Tony the Spider with a turnbuckle holding him up.
Jeff slingshot into the turnbuckle. He's going for the victory roll again. Let's see if he can hold it.
Riding it down.
Yes, he does. He's got it. Referee's counting.
That's the match.
Flynn goes to Jumping Jeff.
Tony the Spider losing the match after coming into the stone. Forget it. Folks, here's Randy Bryant.
Thank you, Buddy Lee. I come to IPW for one reason, Bill Ash. Bill Ash, 2 years ago Christmas night, you took something away from me that nothing on God's green earth can replace. You broke my arm and you broke my shoulder. And it's been two long, long years, Bill Ash. But let me tell you something. I'm bigger, I'm faster, and I'm stronger. And with all them wrestling fans out there behind me, we're taking you out, Ash. We're going to take you out.
We'll be back. We're back. Bulldozer has challenged Richie Rudge for a match twice on television. Richie Rudge has commented he did not really want to get into the ring with a man 100 pounds heavier and a lot more experience. Well, contracts are signed. Everything's taken care of. Everything but the match. Now let's go to the ring and see what happens. Here it is. Richie Rudge in the ring with the Bulldozer.
I'm looking forward to this match, buddy. There's a lot of weight difference.
A lot. Look at Bulldozer. In fact, this was discussed in one of the interviews. Richie discussed how big Bulldozer was.
Just think of the experience Bulldozer has over Richie Rudge.
But the contracts have been signed, so both wrestlers are going to get in here and show us what they can do.
Well, they have to wrestle after they sign the contract.
A lot of emotion surrounding this match.
And right off, Richie Rudge into a top wrist lock on Bulldozer.
Bulldozer with a body slam on Richie Rudge.
And right on top of him, the Bulldozer is.
Richie wasting no time. He's getting out of that.
The Bulldozer just drove an elbow into the back of the head. Now he's putting the leather to Richie Rudge.
Well, this Bulldozer can be a vicious man.
Yes, he can. A slingshot off the ropes, and Bulldozer catches him with a big clothesline.
Bulldozer up, Bulldozer back down with a knee to the midsection and chest of Richie.
And as you know, Bulldozer weighs 300 pounds, so you can imagine the impact of that knee.
That elbow down over the head of Richie. Kick.
He's just putting the leather to him.
Bulldozer snatching Richie back up and back down with an elbow.
I really think that Bulldozer's just trying to teach Richie Rudge a lesson.
Looks like another body slam.
And it is. Bulldozer just standing over Richie Rudge.
Richie Rudge taking punishment in this match. The head of Bulldozer against the head of Richie Rudge.
Kind of like a brick wall, that head of Bulldozer. And then a hard punch to the side of the head.
Richie Rudge, no wonder he didn't want to get in here with this man. Look at the size. Look at what Bulldozer's doing.
What a neck breaker by Bulldozer.
Bulldozer, serious. Richie Rudge, I'm sure, trying to be. But look at what's happening.
Rudge is kicked out of this. I would not have thought it.
Bulldozer pushing Rudge into the corner, slinging him in the other corner.
Here comes Bulldozer, and he misses.
In my opinion, that has got to be one of the biggest upsets this year. Richie Rudge coming out the winner. A surprise to everyone. We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, Bulldozer and Gypsy.
Richie Rudge, you showed me, little man, that you are capable of putting me down for the three count. Something I didn't think was even possible from a little pipsqueak like you. But boy, I'm going to tell you something. I've walked 300,000 miles of barbed wire to get where I am, and I've fought tooth and nail for what I've got. Now, man, I'm going to tell you something, and I say man very lightly, but mister, you be there, boy, and if you think that you can walk over me, if you think that you can even take me, you just be there, boy, because I'm going to leave you laying, mister. You got it?
And now let's go to the ring. In this match, Wild Bill Lash against Rockin' Randy Bryant. Shane, this is going to be quite a match.
There's a lot of history behind this match, and Randy Bryant is shoulder. Bill Ash gets roped. Frustration is built up inside of Ash now.
What do you think about Randy, though? Can you imagine what he feels at home?
I'd hate to be in Bill Ash's shoes, but then again, you've got a man like Bill Ash's experience.
We'll be back to this revenge match in a moment. Back to action, Wild Bill Ash and Rockin' Randy Bryant.
Ash has Brown on the bumper.
Bryant, back up. Ash for the slingshot. Oh,
there's that vicious forearm that Bill Ash delivered.
Randy Bryant taking the punishment he does not want to take in this match.
There's boots to the face by Bill Ash in a cover. Count of two.
Kick out by Randy.
Ash right back on him with a high knee lift.
That is a very vicious knee lift. Randy Bryant at the disadvantage at this point. Now, oh!
There's that short forearm by Bill Ash. Those forearms he throws are vicious.
Randy Bryant getting tired of this action, coming back. Slick shot, drop kick.
He just caught him with the toe of the boot, but it was enough to take Bill Ash to the camera.
Nearly taking Bill Ash out of the ring.
Both men are in big trouble. Randy Bryant using the rope to pull himself to his feet.
Oh, there's the bell.
The time limit draw. The time limit has expired.
These wrestlers are not going to accept that. Nothing has been established.
This is an all-out street fight.
Today is just a sample of the exciting action you'll be seeing in the future on International Pro Wrestling, wrestling the way it should be. I'm your host, Buddy Lee. We'll see you back here next week.